event. A lot to look forward to. Cheering through the mist, some of our Japanese supporters. They've got two competitors in this next race, in Momoko Dekajima and Shoko Ota. Russia with a chance of maybe getting a 1-2. Actually, three athletes in the women's 10K, and Ukraine have four. It's chillier than it has been, just 2 degrees, but the snow remains wet, humidity very high. That puts a few question marks in the minds of the wax technicians, how to get it just right. Taking into consideration the humidity and snow conditions. But it's the women's 10K we're looking forward to. The starters are gathering, 30-second intervals between them. 13 in our first event. And Caroline Bisson of Canada will lead us away from Pamela Navalio of Italy. And towards the end of the start list is where we expect to have our main contenders, particularly Elena Kaufman, Anna Melenina. Kaufman, already a gold medalist in the 6K. 12.5K for the men. Look through the field here. 18 starters this time. And the surprising thing is that we don't have Vladislav Komchev in the field, and he was the winner of the 7.5K. He was also in a cross-country event in the last 24 hours, so he may be feeling the fatigue of that. Alexandra Kononova. She finished 5th in the 6K. Larissa Varona, 12th in that event. And these athletes won't be fazed at all by the conditions. They've raced in it all before. Heavy snow, no snow, wind, sun. Whatever comes their way, just deal with it. And of course, it's the same for all athletes. And that's a terrific complaint. No point putting negative thoughts in your head about the conditions. Yulia Batenkova. My goodness, she's due for her first placing. She's had so many seconds and thirds across her wonderful career. And the neutral observers would be just maybe thinking, surely she's due. Surely she deserves one of those central spots on the podium. But there'll be others with no sympathy for her in the field, and nor should they have. And Kaufman, Melenina. And two Russians to go last and second last. And be after more glory for the host nation. Okay, we're not far from the start then. And up into the gate comes Caroline Bisson. To start. The women's 10K biathlon. And Caroline Bisson has only been skiing for a couple of years. She's got a degree in history and politics from the University of Ottawa. And the Canadian finished 14th in the 6K. She'll be looking for a higher placing here in the 10. Next to go. Caroline Navalio of Italy from Brescia. It's her third game. She was in Torino, in Vancouver. She's had 7th and 8th placings here. A couple of top 10s. And she's on her way. In the 1-2-3 bib. Larissa Verona. Third Paralympic Games for her. Silver and two bronze medals so far in Paralympic Games for Reno and Vancouver. So on a day, could be good enough to challenge the favourites in this event. We'll start towards the bottom of the field. We'll keep the little ones dry and warm. Ludmila Lyashenko of Ukraine from Kharkiv. 20 years of age. Quite a few young competitors in this one. It's going to be exciting to see them develop over the years, and some of them are good enough to win right now. Perhaps not Lyashenko, although she had a seventh in the 6K. Out on the course, we've got checkpoints to keep you up to date with how they're travelling. These give us a good indication of who's on race pace. Natalia Bratyuk, just 16 years of age in the Russian Federation. She is the youngest in the field by a couple of years. Valio, 6 seconds quicker than Bisson. See that first checkpoint. We've got sport classes here, LW6 and LW8. And the appropriate percentage factoring applied to those athletes in consideration of their impairment. As away goes Potenkova. Potenkova third in the 6K. Verona coming through just that little bit quicker than the two in front of her. So the seeding going as it should through these first three competitors at least. Momoko Dekajima from Niigata in Japan. 59 years of age is Momoko. Competed in Vancouver. Lyashenko through the half kilometer checkpoint in 1:34. Irina Bui. Well, she is a serious competitor. She won the 10K at the World Championships last year in biathlon. So a world champion at 18 years of age. Bratyuk is through that first checkpoint. And again, they're just trimming a second or two here and there. Maya Yavala. Fourth in the 6 kilometer biathlon. Visibility here is actually improved from earlier in the day when we wondered if we'd get a start. Fortunately, we've been able to keep on schedule. Potenkova a little slower through the half kilometre. It's got to be some concern to her if she's going to medal again or put herself in a gold medal winning position, but she might like her chances better in the cross country rather than biathlon. We'll see. Dekajima, just outside the times of Bratyuk. Just a second with Lyashenko. Alexandra Kononova. Two gold medals in Vancouver in cross country and one gold in biathlon. Kononova fifth in the 6K biathlon. Not to be confused with Svetlana Kononova, who's also in the cross-country and biathlon program. Bui coming through 7 seconds outside the time of Bratyuk. So just a couple to go now out of the start gate, and we'll have all our field in action. And Anna Malenina, the 27-year-old Russian, gets a big cheer as she leaves the starting area. Second in the 6K. Yavala coming through 1.6 seconds outside Bratyuk's time. Carefully negotiating the uphill section, using the inside of the skis for leverage. Alana Kaufman, gold medalist from the 6 kilometer event. And away she goes. 36-year-old is very much missing her young daughter Karina while she's been training and preparing for these games. Soon enough, she'll be back in the arms of the family and with at least one gold medal to show them. Kanonova. Looks like she'll spin 5 seconds indeed off Bratchik's time at the first checkpoint. So all the field is away. And in fact, we've got Caroline Bisson of Canada into the range for the first time. 5 2-kilometre laps and 4 visits to the shooting range. And here's the first of them. So 20 shots in all, or 20 targets they have to hit. And if they miss them, there are penalty loops to do. Bisson. She weren't with us earlier in this day's competition. I'd be unaware that the conditions were considerably worse before. These are air rifles. And a miss there for Bisson. So there's 150 metres extra she's going to have to ski. Oh, 2 misses. That's not good. However, we'll leave that to the officials and team members to sort out. And she drops the rifle. Grishenko. Navalio's already left the range. I'm just checking Navalio on my scoring monitor here. She shot clean. So no penalties for Navalio. 2 for Bisson, 1 for Verona. And Lyushenko shot clear, and Bratchuk likewise. So Lyushenko, 29 seconds to the good there, and 1-2-4 is her big number today. I wonder if, like a lot of athletes, if they're superstitious and they have a win in a certain bid number, then they'd like that one next time. But you don't get too much choice about these things. Batenkova. Timing of the breathing and the shooting obviously crucial. Keep the chest steady. Stop breathing, heart pounding, and she's got 5 out of 5. Well done to Batenkova. Not especially quick though through this first lap. Even though she's 5 out of 5, she'll still be well outside the time of Natalia Bratsyuk. All the equipment that brings you the broadcast will stand up to the rain that we've had today and keep it all dry and keep bringing you these wonderful pictures from Laura. Even if the conditions are not what we want, we've still got important races and exciting ones to bring you. And it hasn't kept the crowd away. I'm really pleased that some have braved the conditions to come and support the athletes. It means so much to them. We're in a Buey now. Got a steady hand. Top right of the picture, Yarvela is into the range as well. 5 out of 5 for Buey. And away she goes. You see a tug on the trigger finger on the glove there. That's because they generally have a hole cut in that right index finger if they're right-handed, or whatever the trigger finger might be, and then they pull it out of the glove to get that extra feel on the trigger. Then as they leave the range, they push it back into the glove so it doesn't get too cold. So interview back out onto her second lap then. Kanonova. Just one breath between shots. That's pretty efficient for Kanonova, and 5 out of 5. And she might have the new best time with two athletes behind her in Melenina and Kaufman. And on about missing out on a medal in the 6K. Here is Malenina, who finished second in that event. The first one on the program for the women's standing category. With a couple of misses there, and Malenina is in early trouble. Cannot afford any more. 20 shots in all through the four visits. And those two misses need to be the only ones she has. Now the race favourite and the champion from the 6K. She's very quick to match a Kanonova. In fact, she can't really. That's all right, it's only early. Oh, and a miss. Here we go. That's opened the race right up. So Kaufman has got an extra lap to do of the penalty loop. And that puts Kanonova neatly in front. So we'll wait to see after Kaufman has done her penalty loop just how far behind she is, but Kanonova coming through the 2.5K inside Bratchuk's time. So now she's a 14-second leader over Bratchuk. Yavala is over a minute behind. The pin, and I wonder what Kaufman can do about this little imposition she's put on herself with that miss. Kaufman, check her progress. So she on my screen is 40 seconds down on Kanonova. Yavala continuing to make her way up this ascent. In this freestyle technique of skiing, only glide wax applied to the ski, and they use the inside edge and the pole to help them to the uphill and flat section. So realizing that they don't have a complete field, Ashoko Ota of Japan has not started. It's just become evident on our screens that a little late to let us know. Sometimes in the flurry of activity while we chase the early starters and then come back to the start, you can always see whether everyone actually makes it to the start line. And so is the case today. Ashoko Ota has missed it. Bratchuk. 4 out of 4, still no penalties. And Natalia Bratchuk, youngest in the field, is showing maturity well beyond her years. At 16, she's 10 out of 10. And long distance camera really struggling to pick up the athletes. 21 seconds, but the conditions are worsening. They change quite quickly here at Laura. And Bratchuk, 21 seconds in front for the moment, but we haven't had Kanonova come through with the second shoot. Continuing to rain. Visibility, though, is still good enough. Very quickly. And it's going to get harder and harder to pick up the athletes as the clouds move in. If you're not aware of some of the technical aspects of Paralympic biathlon, the targets are 10 metres away from the athlete. Here's Bekajima now. She's had one miss in the second shoot. And one only. So she's 9 out of 10 overall. Yes, the target's just 10 metres away. So when the visibility is poor, we've at least still got a chance of conducting the event. In Olympic biathlon, the distance is 50 metres from athlete to target. So when the clouds close in, Often we get a postponement, as we did in the Olympic Winter Games. Bisson, shoot penalties with the first shoot. Taking the time with his third shot, got it away well though. And 5 out of 5, that's a good improvement from Caroline Bisson of Canada. And in comes Kononova now. This is a very important couple of minutes in the context of the event. What's happened here? She's got some obstruction in the rear sight. It's taken a while to get set. All valuable seconds, with Bratchuk having cleared the area in 12 minutes and 9 seconds. Kononova hasn't let it phase her. 4 out of 4. And Kononova, the team member coming in to take the rifle away almost before she'd finished, and even to be aware of that person's presence would be a little annoying. Kononova is still 8 seconds in front of Bratchuk. Oh, what a good race we got here. Ukraine and Russia, first and second. So it's Kononova from Bratchuk. In third place at the moment is Dekajima of Japan. We've got to see what happens here with Kaufman and Malanina. Malanina had 2 misses with her first visit, so she's got the shoot clear here. And so does Kaufman, who's just come into the range as well. Malenina can just keep knocking them down without another mistake and let the others have their turn at missing, perhaps she could be back in it. And it's getting harder and harder. Here's Kaufman. 5 out of 5. That's more like what we're used to seeing from Milena Kaufman. Away she goes. Time out of the range for second time, 12 minutes flat, and 19 seconds behind is Kaufman. Well, there's lots of this race still to go. Those ones just leaving the range now. They skied 4 kilometres out of the 10. Kononova, 11.7 seconds quicker than Bratchuk. So here in this third lap, she's just starting to increase the tempo a little. I'm a little concerned myself about the deteriorating visibility. Meanwhile, the men's 12.5k standing is about to start, so that will get underway with the women's event still going. That will cause a few moments of confusion for all of us, especially in the average visibility we have. Witold Skupien of Poland will be first to go as the men's event gets underway. Skupien from Novosadsk in Poland. So the men's 12.5k standing biathlon commences. 18 in the field, assuming they all get underway. Bratchuk, third shoot for her, and the Russian 16-year-old. I keep emphasizing her youth. I keep admiring the way she's performing. Well, that's incredible. 15 out of 15. a natural shooter, I would say, is Natalia Brachuk, to be that good that young. Well, Brachuk well inside the time of Leoshenko, as expected. Next to come in, Yulia Batenkova. Now, Batenkova just not skiing quickly enough today. She hasn't had a miss. I don't know where she can make up the difference. Oh, there's her first miss. Thought she didn't take quite enough time to settle. Maybe one more breath before that first shot. There we go. So 150 metres extra to ski. That'll put her perhaps off the podium. Sushanka is underway in the men's 12.5K. The Belarusian who finished 14th in the 7.5K event. He's just turned up 42. Vitaly Sitnik of Ukraine. Sitnik, a 15th finish in the other biathlon event that's already been contested for this class. Sitnik from Kharkiv. Men and women standing athletes sharing the course at the moment as in comes Kononova, our race leader. Shows great patience getting herself set here, but making sure everything is how she wants it before she starts knocking down these targets. And there's her first miss, Kononova. And that should put the Brachuk in the lead after Kononova gets back out onto the course. 18:26 for Brachuk. And with Kononova having to ski the penalty loop, we'll see what that means shortly. Navalio coming through 6.5Ks. The women's event is a 10K event, the men's 12.5. Barnio almost 2.5 minutes behind the Brachuk through that checkpoint. Batenkova in third at the moment. Now Kaufman. A clean shoot here and she's back in the race because Kononova has missed. Kaufman with the experience and stamina to run down Brachuk, I'd suggest. And oh, she's done it. She had just had that early miss, and then it was business as usual for Alina Kaufman, the gold medalist from the 6K, looking for a second top spot here. And she is about to assume the lead. She does by 10.5 seconds, Kaufman. That's Kaufman and Brachuk in the women's race. As away goes Pronkov, Alexander Pronkov of the Russian Federation. And also got Kirill Mikhailov and Azat Karachurin to come in the men's race. But this is Kodlozorov out on the course. Russia with a very strong representation in the 12.5K. Here's Kirill Mikhailov. We're starting off with great energy and a frenetic beginning from Mikhailov, who was fourth in the 7.5K, wants to get on the podium. Kononova, 3 seconds behind Bratschuk there, but the new player in the pack was Kaufman. If he's going across to Davier. It's going to be confusing as you've got men passing women and vice versa. Here is Kaufman. Looking for her time through the 6.5K. Bratschuk to beat. And what's the margin going to be? Not much. 12 seconds. Kaufman. It was 10 seconds. So actually, Kaufman has just increased that margin by a couple. Now, Bratschuk, 16-year-old. Have a chance here of tipping Kaufman out of top spot. Oh, she needed to shoot clear. I didn't even get the thought out before it happened. I'm not going to say it was a commentator's curse then. I hadn't had the opportunity to finish the sentence, but Bratschuk, well, 19 out of 20 is still awesome shooting for a 16-year-old. Niels Erik Uset, who finished sixth in the 7.5K for the men's standing. The Norwegian is on his way. And just two to come after him. Mark Arendt of Canada and Azat Karachurin of Russia. Good field in the men's, and the conditions as they are, if anything, making it more intriguing. A bigger test for the athletes. Here's Mark Arendt, silver medalist in the 7.5K. Canadian stepping his way down this first 100 metres or so before he leaves the stadium. And this is Ihor Repchuk. That's to the rain count. Potenkova. Last five shots. Chance of a medal finish slipping through the grasp of Bychenkova. Just can't find that target in the sights. Doesn't want to squeeze the trigger until she does. Got it. Okay, one more. This time, maybe. Yes. Well, she took three attempts with the breathing and aiming to find it, and it was worth the wait. Again, I say that 10, 15 seconds wasted is better than 25. Arendt, behind the time of Davier through that checkpoint, as we look at the men's race and women's, it's going on at the same time. It's hectic. It's just a lot to try and take in. Karachurin, last man out of the gate in the men's 12.5K, on his way. Davier of France, one of the earliest starters in the middle of the field. Kanonova. Important few moments coming up here. She's just had the one miss. Cannot afford any more. Keep the pressure on Kaufman. Not that Kaufman seems to be worried by pressure ever. But Kanonova has done what she can. 19 out of 20. Great shooting from Alexandra Kanonova of Ukraine. Kanonova finished out of the medals in the 6K. I think it's going to be a different story in this one. Kaufman now. 4 out of 4. You know what's coming here. 5 out of 5. One miss very early on in the competition, and Kaufman I'm not going to make another mistake. And I'm heading off to try and get another gold medal here. She's got one from the 6K. And she's such a good skier. Now the margin's out to 28 seconds. She's continuing to build. She's getting better and better as the race goes on. Mikhailov, Russian Federation, first shoot. And first miss for Kirill. 4 out of 5, Kirill Mikhailov. Need to be 100% from here on in. Natalia Bratsyuk out on the course, and at 16 years of age, can she medal in this 10K? Anna Milanina just made a couple too many mistakes today, with those around her just missing one or so, and she's missed three. Here's Bobchinsky of Ukraine. He's missed his first, at his first stop as well. Irina Bui, a minute 50 behind Kanonova. Bui's performance today, although she actually shot clear, the 18-year-old, but she's not quick across the snow. I wonder if she's got not the best wax on the skis, as she's about to be passed by Alana Kaufman. Kaufman still full of energy. Stamina not an issue. And a couple of misses early on for Ihor Repchuk of Ukraine. Sekretima, 2 minutes outside Kaufman's time at the 8.5K. So 1.5 kilometers to ski for Sekretima. Also. One deep breath between shots. Alsett's done it nicely. 5 out of 5. Bratsyuk out on the course. Coming into the finish line now. And Natalia Bratsyuk. An excellent race. 30 minutes 57. And that's it. I'm done, she says. And she's done a great job. The Olympic logo, the Agitas. Handed on a cheek. That's great to see. She has really given it everything, learning at a young age to crash through the pain barrier. 2 minutes 10 down on Kaufman's time. It's Milanino. The silver medal performance from the other day must seem a distant memory. She's not up to it today. Missed too many targets, 4 of them in fact. Katachurin, one of the top seeds for the men's event. Into the range for the first time and knocks over the first couple without issue. And 5 out of 5, it is. The Katachurin, as you can see, skis without stocks. Katachurin in the LW57 sport class has an 88% factoring applied to his total time. Shanka of Belarus. She's 50 seconds behind Prontov. Miss at the range will knock your time around. Now into the home straight. We've got Petenkova. Not challenging Bratsyuk. There are some good times to come in behind her. So Batenkova, I don't think this is going to be a medal winning performance from her. She's in third at the moment, minute six behind Bratchuk, and we've still got Kaufman out there. And Kananova. She's got a busy program, and it's got to be taking its toll on her. Bisson coming through at 8.5 k's, so 1.5 to go for the Canadian. Okay, heading down to the line now is Kananova. She's got Bratchuk's time, inside it by 23.9, and now she has to wait for Kaufman, but it's almost inevitable that Kaufman will eclipse her as well. Here comes Kaufman, and here comes another gold medal performance from her, Elena Kaufman, 2 out of 2 in the biathlon. Navalio also finishes almost exactly 5 minutes behind what should be the winning time. Kananova and Kaufman exchanging congratulations there. Wonderful camaraderie amongst these athletes. They get a great feel out of seeing it. Perhaps that's a moment of what sport really should be about. Camaraderie, competition, yes. Do your best, yes. Respect your opponent. That's right up there as well, and these athletes do. Dekajima from Japan. And down to the line, through the mist. Oh, again, the conditions seem to be getting a bit worse. 3:24 down on Kaufman's time. And then quickly out of the skis and out of the way. She knows there's traffic coming. So lightly making room for it. Yavala, who had a good start to the race, Maya Yavala. Let's see what happened to her here. She missed just 2 targets on the day and slowed down in the second half around the course. That's probably as much to explain it. 3:23 behind Kaufman. And here comes Anna Melenina. Inside the top six, yes. She's done better than that. Had a silver medal out of the 6K biathlon. But just couldn't put it together today. Melenina. 4 penalties in all. 2 missed at the first stop. And that summed it up. Little transponders taken off the ankle that give us our checkpoint time. Kaufman it is. No surprise. She had to work hard for it. Kananova and Bratchuk in particular took it to her. But Elena Kaufman's got a calmness about her. And even when little things go wrong, as they did at the first visit to the range, she's able to forget it, move on. He's having a bad time at the range. He's shooting himself out of contention with that shoot. Arends. No misses at the first stop. And the Canadian needs to keep this accurate shooting going if he is to challenge the likes of Karachurin and Pronkov. Mark Allen showing the form that got him a silver medal in the 7.5 k. He putting himself in contention again. Excuse me. Skipping around that tight right-hand turn as they leave the range, and he's just inside Pronkov's time. So things looking promising for the young Canadian. Given that a bit more of a cheer if they could have seen it. The visibility is just not good enough, so they love to cheer the 5 out of 5, or as each target goes down without a miss, particularly for the host nation athletes. But he's 6.5 seconds in front, he's Katachurin. Of Belarus. Third shoot for him. A couple of misses so far. And another. So one each. The first three stops. Five more shots to come for him. No penalties so far for Sitnik. For Ukraine's having a good event. This is the men's 12.5K standing category. All sorts of ways to get the breathing and firing done. The 1.5 breaths is also quite a popular rhythm to establish. So one big breath and then breathe in again and then half exhale. But Lazarov dropped one at the first shoot, none at the second, none at the third. So it's 14 out of 15 for Lazarov. And he will be inside that time of Sitnik by quite a margin. But it's only halfway through the field. It's 18 in this men's 12.5K. But Lazarov carving a good amount at Sitnik's time. And Harkonnen. Taking a few extra moments to get set, and three misses at the first shoot. That's a mini disaster for Juha Harkonnen. I'm happy with the setup again. Mikhailov, top of your screen, and the Russian getting set. Harkonnen's having all sorts of trouble here. Mikhailov, meanwhile, has missed one. Harkonnen's having trouble firing two, and he's missed the second. And third. For pellets then. A little mystified about that one, but Harkonnen, disappointing for him and frustrating, and ultimately a little land to finish very high up in the field. Anyway, here comes Alexander Plonkov. No penalty so far for the Russian. Wolfinski of Ukraine going well. Oh no, he's missed one. Plonkov, meanwhile, 4 out of 5. Plonkov, 4 out of 4. And make that 15 out of 15. Three successful visits to the range. And Plonkov is off. He finished 10th in the 7.5K. He's heading for a much better finish in the longer race. Tonkov getting the early time to beat there. Let's see if I've got the earlier result from that race where he had, over the shorter race, he had two penalties, and that was one each at the two stops. In the 7.5K, they only have two visits to the range, and Pronkov missed on both times, so shooting much better in the longer event. And we're expecting something better from Ihor Repchuk, but you can see how misses knock around your chances of a big finish. Five penalties now for Repchuk. Meanwhile, Arendt's third shoot for him. Oh, the Canadian racks up his first miss. It's okay though, he's 14 out of 15. You'd take that as a pass, as a very good pass in your English assignment, wouldn't you? Pulls it. Up Norway. Thirty-year-old from Trondheim. A lot of the Nordic and Alpine skiers are based in the Norwegian Olympic and Paralympic programs. All set. Shoots clear again. Now he's one of the seeds here. He only finished sixth. When I say only, he might have been expecting a podium finish in the 7.5K. And now Ulsett finds himself with a 20-second lead over Pronkov. And one more shooting bout to come. Through the gloom, they're making their way around the course here. Five laps of 2.5 kilometres. Four turns at the shooting. Vitaly Skupian in the number one bib. In two is Juha Hakkinen. Kapitulian. Oh, gets it done very efficiently, doesn't he? Takes the glove right off, which is his preferred technique, obviously. And it works for him, too. Katachurian, the new leader, 15 seconds quicker than Ulsic, exiting the range for the third time. And he is the world number one, Azat Katachurian. Arends, 50 seconds behind Pronkov. I think it's going to be a second place for Arends. If this trend continues, the best he might hope for is third. Ulsek and Katachurin, who started before and after him. Here is Ulsek. And Pronkov. Ushanka. Saved his best to last, 5 out of 5 with his final shoot. Junker, he's just turned 42. Back out onto the course, one lap to go. The athletes will tell themselves when that moment of the race comes around. Himself a quick talking to, come on, finish this, give it your absolute best. Last lap, Karachurin leading this race. Sato in the range. He missed one so far. About 19 out of 20. Yes, he's got it. 95%. Great shooting from Sato. Into the mist and rain. Kalyov. Two penalties so far. Five out of five here, and a few other things to go his way. Perhaps get a podium finish. It's unlikely. Another miss plays in out of the reckoning, I believe. Kalyov, that's not good enough. Not when others are shooting around 90-95%. Shilchenko through the 10.5K. Means he's got 2 kilometres to ski. And for Lazarov's time, just that little bit better. 15 is Yanamchuk. Haven't seen a lot of Alexander to this point. Just one at the second shoot. The last. Oh, he needed that. Now Kronkov. Missed with his first. And his first miss of the day. And there's his second. Oh, it's unraveling. Shake of the head. He knows. Now he's got 300 metres extra to ski. Xavier of France. Five out of five with the last, that's well done. The toughest shoot of the event, and the body's hurting the most. Crying out for oxygen, and you stop breathing to pull the trigger. And the body doesn't like that. Davier. Off the pace of Kodlozarov, sure, but had a pretty good outing as the Frenchman. Seven penalties already. He's had troubles with the rifle. He's out ends. Canadian got to get them all. Harkonnen, you're wondering where that form was earlier. And he racked up seven penalties. Arendt, three out of three. And Mark Arendt, don't count him out just yet. See what the others do in their last visit. Harkonnen, 7 minutes 20 down on Pronkov's time. That's being arranged for the final time. Usyk. There's his first miss. I think he might have someone go through clean, and he's ended up with two misses. That's got to hurt. Bermejo, this is... Omar Bermejo. Karachurin. Right, here's our race leader. Hasn't missed yet. He's so steady when he stops breathing. But he does miss one. All right, Karachurin played some others into the race perhaps, but we've just seen a couple of misses from Ulsit. Mark Arendt, I wonder if he just might be able to pull something off here. A little bit hard to predict what might happen now, but Arendt, one miss. Karachurin, one miss. Kodlozarov and Sato, one miss. Sato, the Japanese competitor, is not fast enough around the course. Karachurin, still a leader though. Yeah, he's too quick for Aaron. And even with that miss, Karachurin finds himself with a good lead. Down to the finish now comes Kotlazarov. Ivan Kotlazarov, 31.07. Lushanka, 2 minutes behind him. The athletes have dealt very well with these difficult conditions. Repchuk is more than a couple of minutes behind Arendt through the 10.5K. Arendt, Kronkov. Bulsit. See who's going to fight for these minor medals. It still looks like Karachurian's race. He hasn't yet come through the 10.5K, but not far away. Sitnik coming down to the line. A couple of minutes outside Kotlazarov. Sato there as well, 1:32 behind. Sato had very good discipline at the range. Karachurian, 48 seconds in front of Ulset. Karachurian, Ulset and Arendt might well be our medalists. We'll see. Kotlazarov and Mikhailov holding down 1-2 for Russia at the moment, but things are about to change. We've got six who finish. Animated, but it looks like reasonably happy discussion going on. I hope so. I don't want any protest or anything like that to happen. Ostrenko, he's finished. 13 is Yaramchuk. Yaramchuk just got the right-hand turn to make, and then around in front of the grandstand for the final time. He's down there somewhere, folks. There he is. Alexander Yaramchuk from the Russian Federation. Won't displace Kotlazarov. He's inside the time of Sato comfortably. He'll know there's a danger behind him in terms of threatening his time. Lovchinsky of Ukraine into third. But we're sweating on the arrival of Ulset, Arendt and Karachurin. Not many to come in. There's Benjamin Davier for France. Top five finish at the moment. Bold effort. The absence of Vladislav Lakomtsev, who won the 7.5K, has opened this right up. Now Mark Arendt coming down to the line. 31.07 to beat. He's going to do that. Kotlazarov's time well and truly under threat from Arendt. And Pronkov into second. Gomeo finishes one of the early starters, well off the pace, 6.51 or so. Athlete from the USA. Rokov face down in the snow. So at the moment it's Arendt, Pronkov and Kotlazarov. Canada, Russia, Russia. And we've got Azat Karachurin out on the course coming in shortly. Michael Kurtz there of Austria in the snow. Coming in now, Juha Hakkinen. Had a very mixed day. some problems with his rifle. Kurtz, like the Austrian, looks like he very much enjoys competition and the camaraderie of his fellow athletes. Here comes Ihor Repchuk. Out of the medals, I'm afraid, today. Just didn't quite have it together. Mark Arendts of Canada waiting to see if Katachurin can beat his time, and it's almost certain that he will. Is that Katachurin? Not yet. It's Ulset who's coming in, and he's got Arendts by 6 seconds. So the Norwegian into first place. Gets a tap of congratulations. I don't think he wanted it straight away. He needs to recover first. Skupion of Poland comes in the number one bib. But here comes Azat Karaturin across the line, 54 seconds ahead of Ulset. And here's our champion, world champion and Paralympic champion. Gets warm congratulations on his opponent. That's Nils Erik Ulset, straight up to him to say, well done, too good. And Azat Karaturin, who was that today, just missed one target. So did Arendts. They finished first and third. Ulset missed two and finished second. But that, I think, will be that. And we've got the field through now. Karaturin, Ulset and Arendts. Women's standings, first of all, in the 10K, Elena Kaufman from Alexandra Kononova and Natalia Brachuk, Russia, Ukraine, Russia. Then Lyushenko, Batenkova, Malanina and Bui from Ukraine and Russia, sharing it between those two nations. Then the Finn, Yavala, Dekajima of Japan. Verano didn't finish. Ota didn't quite make it to the start. Well, these trying conditions have certainly thrown a whole new perspective into the race. Variables that the athletes learn to deal with, they probably prefer not to have to, but indifferent visibility and rain on and off. They've done a good job, though. Events for you today, the women's visually impaired 10k and the men's 12.5k, and they aren't far away. About a 25 minute pause, and then we'll have two more events and then the flower presentations for all four. Hope you can stay with us for some more action and excitement from Laura. Confirming the 12.5k standing result, Azat Karachurin from Nils Erik Ulset, Russia, Norway, and then Mark Ahrens of Canada. Tronkov, Podlozarov, and Mikhailov of Russia, Ukraine's Voshinsky, Benjamin Davier of France, a good race from him to finish ninth. In 18th position, Sato for Japan, a good 10th from him, Sitnik, Lepchuk and Maslenko, Ukraine 12, 13, 14. And there are your 18 competitors in the 12.5k standing.
Thank you. and country medalists. Cross country.
Getting ready for our last couple of events on the day's competition at the Lauda Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. Visually impaired races for the men and women. 10Ks for the women, 12.5Ks for the men. And the women will start first, but soon to be followed by a start in the men's. And the races will be running simultaneously after about 15 minutes. Concurrently is a better word. They will be running at alongside each other, but the women will start first. I hope that made some kind of sense. Snow is wet, the air temperature 2 degrees, high humidity. We've got some rain around today. No wind around the Laura Cross Country Centre, although down below in the resorts there's been a bit today. Just a small field in the women's 10K visually impaired. Nikolaina Listova of the Russian Federation is a warm favourite to collect a second gold medal. Olga Prilutska, Oksana Shishkova, Yulia Idlieva and Nikolaina Listova is your field and their respective guides around the course. Five laps, four shooting bouts. And the men's field, 10 competitors, and five of them from Ukraine, three from Russia, one from Belarus, one from Germany. Nikolai Polukhin at the bottom of the list there, a warm favourite. But the Vitaly Lukyanenko of Ukraine, having won the 7.5K, also must be considered. So the visibility isn't great, but it hasn't stopped us from conducting all our races today, I'm pleased to say. So we remain on schedule. Oksana Shishkova, the guide Lada Nestorenko. Shishkova and Lisova in the 6K event didn't miss a target between them. They have to shoot twice as many rounds today. Lisova with a win in the 6K and a second place in the cross-country event also, so she's moving along nicely through her events. Prilutska will go out first, leave in 30-second intervals. So Olga Prilutska. Whilst the visibility isn't too special, we've been able to get the events done, and I'm less concerned at the range for visually impaired athletes because they use an audio-guided electronic rifle. Tough and long day for the officials making the right calls on whether we can continue.
30 seconds to the start.
Olga Prilutska, ready to go. And the women's 10K visually impaired biathlon. Sochi, are you ready for the start? So the 21-year-old from Kiev gets us underway. Making a brisk and aggressive start to the race. Unfortunately for Olga, she did not finish the earlier biathlon race. They'll be looking to make amends here. Put a good race together. Oksana Shishkova next to go. Bronze medalist in the 6K. And the guide is Lada Nestorenko. Interested to see that the name Nestorenko bobs up in Prilutska's support team. More about that later. Yulia Budalieva. On the way. Budalieva from Tumen in the Russian Federation. The guide, Tatiana Maltseva. Been training just 4 years ago for this type of event. And Mikulina Lisova, one of the real stars of the Russian Paralympic team, the gold medalist in the 6K, silver medalist in the cross country, and it looks good coming through the first checkpoint in minute 40. Visibility is a little different from when they're up close. Petushkova coming through 6 seconds faster than Felitska. It's Olga Felitska's coach is Andrei Nestorenko. And Petushkova's guide is Lara Nestorenko. Couldn't be sure whether there's a connection there. Both coming from Ukraine, perhaps there is. Vitalieva, again, just a little bit quicker. The athletes are seeded in such a way as to indicate that should be the case. And then Lisova will be quicker again by 8 seconds. So she starts last. Is the better performed of the athletes in the race. At least if there is to be an issue for her, it might be fatigue, because she's putting herself through a pretty big program of events. She's down to compete in 7, including a mixed relay, 3 biathlon, 3 cross-country. Well, she's already been in a 15K event, and that would have taken something out of her. Her age, just 21, hasn't really built up the endurance that she might have in a few years' time. Down in the start-finish area, the men are preparing for their race. It's not far away from the start for them, in a little over 10 minutes. So they will be racing out on the course at the same time as the women. 10 in the men's field, 4 in the women. Plenty of room for them at the range.
After these two competitions,
not to observe how the visually impaired biathletes shoots, and that will be interesting for you. As I mentioned, they use an audio frequency through their headphones at the range to guide them towards where the target is, and they adjust to the changing sound of the frequency to locate where the target is, pull the trigger, and then the rifle is able to register whether they are on target or not. Sochi is not yet the Paralympic Games of Olga Pilutska, says the coach. He's got eyes down the track. Next Games, 2018 in Korea. That's where they really think that Olga Pilutska will be blossoming. She's just turned 21. So in the mid-20s, late-20s, even early-30s, that's when you can get the best years out of biathlon and cross-country athletes. Lisova is in the B2 sport class, along with Petushkova and Vitalieva, who looks to slightly better sighted in the B3 class. So into the range they come, and watch and listen as the athletes do their best. Okay, if we go into the maximum sound, the highest pitch is there. And there's a miss for Petushkova. And four out of five. So she's got one penalty, Lutsiski. Politska. Over top of screen. One miss, three shots down. Politska, four out of four. And Politska, just a little pause over that last shot, but she's done well, Ukrainian, to get five out of five. So I hope you are able to understand how that was working for them. The higher the frequency, the closer they are to the target. They know what the maximum frequency is, so when they are in line with the target, the press on the trigger, and hopefully that means a successful shot. So about 6-7 minutes away from the start of the men's event. The women have already made one visit to the range. At least a couple of them have. Seen up to date with the result through that first stop. There was one penalty for Shishkova and Bidalieva, but none for Politska or Lisova. So now Lisova has got a 50-second lead over Bidalieva and Shishkova, and a minute 48 over Politska. There's Olga Politska. The other athletes you see might be closer than that margin suggests, but she, Politska, because she's in the B3 class, has 100% of her real time registered as in race time. But the other three athletes in the B2 category, 98% of real time only is their race time. So the sun comes off, and she stood up. A minute four behind Lee stood up. Bidalieva, also about a minute behind Lisova. 55 seconds in fact. And Politska, 210 down. She's in the inside of the ski and the poles to give them purchase in the uphill section. Just a little quicker tempo coming from Bidalieva there than we saw from Politska. They can keep the progress through this top section of the course. Clouds and a little bit of rain still with us. It won't be helping what snow we have left. That's the fourth. We're through to the end of these 2014 Paralympic Winter Games. We're starting to get busy down around the start finish area because of the men's race, which is just, let's see, about 4 minutes away now. There's been no change of heart from the jury about whether the conditions are good enough to start the men's race. Fidelieva, 41 seconds behind Lisova. Means 12.5K. He's about to get underway. Through the range comes Olga Kulitska for the second shoot. She shot clean on the first occasion. There, first time for Kulitska. Second one. So three out of five, second time. Vasily Shatsboy for Belarus is away in the men's visually impaired 12.5K. In the bid 33 with his guide Mikhail Lebedzu. Already out on the course, Dmitry Shulga of Ukraine and Yaroslav Reshevsky. Bychenok is well behind the pace of Lisova now, which is a good pace indeed. Oleg Ponomarev, who had a 10th placing in the 7.5K biathlon, the men physically impaired. And Andrei Romanov is his guide. Jeff Shaboy went through that first 500 meter checkpoint. And a good brisk time. 56 is Yuriel Utkin, who finished just outside the medals in the 7.5K biathlon with a fourth placing. Vitaly Kazakov is the Ukrainian guide. Five Ukrainians out of 10 competitors. I'll certainly be hoping to get a medal or two. First checkpoint is not much into the race, just half a kilometer. Ponomarev outside Shatsuboy's time. Shatsuboy was a surprise withdrawal in the middle of a cross-country event the last 48 hours or so. Kovalevsky of Ukraine. Guide Alexander Mukshin. And just two to go. To leave the start gate. Utkin. Shatsuboy's time holding up nicely at the half-kilometer checkpoint. Gold medalist from the 7.5K biathlon, is Vitaly Lukyanenko, with Boris Belar, his guide. He's a bit of a surprise winner in that first race. Third shoot for Lusova. Oh goodness, she thought that. She has just so much quicker than her rivals that section of the race. Budalieva. Keep it down to just one miss, she can. That last target met very quickly. So well done for Budalieva. Lisova is really in control of this race. It's not surprising. She's the gold medalist from the 6K. And Budalieva off the pace being set by Lisova. Dmitry Shulga into the range. The men's 12.5K. Last year at the World Championships for Rushetsky, and he was shooting like that. Might have been how he got it done. Shepchevoy, the problems for him early on. He misses, shake of the head, disappointment. Spit in disgust as much as anything, perhaps. 300 metres extra to ski. Nobody likes that. Fishkova, 2.56 down on Lisova's time. Lisova is just totally in control, not only of the skiing and shooting, but of this race. 10K. So Lisova looks like picking up her third medal from as many races and her second gold. Panomarev, Russian Federation. One-year-old from Perm. 10th in the 7.5K. Up a bronze medal in the 1K sprint in the World Championship last year, did Panomarev. Ipkin now from Kharkiv, 23 years of age. Veteran of Vancouver Games, where he had two top 10 finishes, Ipkin. Is our new leader with 3.5 seconds inside the time of Kruger. Kovalevsky now. men's field just loaded with athletes from Ukraine. See if they can get one, two, or perhaps three onto the podium. Not quite so lucky. They've made a big race from Utkin. He did finish fourth in the 7.5K biathlon. Kovalevsky, sixth in that race. And five out of five to start with. Litvinenko, the surprise winner of the 7.5 kilometer biathlon, managed to push Nikolai Pelukin off the top of the podium. Oh my goodness, he's skilled at that. Makes it look easy. Now Pelukin. Can't afford any misses with Litvinenko in such good form for Ukraine. He's 3 out of 3, Pelukin. Five out of five. And away he goes. Oh, there's a miss. Don't see that often. But only the one, and I don't think it's going to hurt Lisova. So she's got one penalty loop to ski, then they're out around the course again. And two more kilometres, and she'll have another Paralympic title in her pocket. Vodilieva. Another 5 out of 5 for Vodilieva. Vodilieva and Shishkova cutting it out for the minor medals in the women's event. And the men's, though, it's Litvinenko and Kovalevsky. Not much between them. Conditions certainly not getting any better. It's pretty tough out there. Litvinenko, looking back through the results from the other race, the 7.5K. Pelukin missed one target in the first of two shooting bouts, but Litvinenko didn't miss, and he won by 11 seconds, and it's that fine a margin. Miss one against a rival who's near your quality, and if he doesn't miss, then you've certainly got a battle on your hands to make up the difference out on the course. Pelukin, guided by Andrei Tokarev. Lisova on the left. And Vodilieva. And Lisova by 29.5 seconds. Side by side, and Lisova started 30 seconds behind Vodilieva. Rushetsky now. Yaroslav. He's 10 out of 10. And the Ukrainian playing his part and trying to get his nation up onto a dominant position on the podium with five competitors in the field. Shishkova, meanwhile, where she's placed here, she's looking at a third place finish. Vodilieva looks safe in second. Back to the men. Shachaboy, a couple of penalties with his first visit. He looked disgusted with himself when it happened. And there's another one. 4 out of 5. That's your boy. Номерев. And this is first time around. He got first this time. Sugar. 13 minutes 33 out of the second shoot. So Numerev, if he's efficient enough, ought to be able to get near that time. Numerev, fifth starter. Sugar went out first. Panomarev could be right there. He's got more than half a minute to get to the checkpoint. Utkin. I think too much extraneous noise gets in through those headphones of the crowd reacting to whatever else might be going on in the stadium. 5 out of 5 for Utkin. Kovalevsky. Six in the 7.5K biathlon. Not so many others trying to shoot clean here. And he is waiting for that high pitch sound. Finds it, shoots it. 10 out of 10 for Kovalevsky. They've got two not starting in this men's event. They've been Wilhelm Brehm of Germany and Russia's Vladimir Dukov. Pace with what's going on in this race. There are so many athletes getting through the range with 5 out of 5 each time. Palukin can add his name to that. Yes, he's 10 out of 10, so Palukin. Kovalevsky's 12:24 to beat, and he is racing to do that. Palukin, oh, the visibility's getting really bad now. Raceable. Podolieva coming down to the finish of the women's event in what'll be just under 31 minutes. 30:38 for Podolieva, but Lisova across in 30 minutes 11.5 seconds and 27 seconds quicker than Podolieva. And that's going to be a second gold medal for Mikhailina Lisova. Kovalevsky out on the course. We've got coming up now, Litvinenko through. 5 seconds down on Kovalevsky. Litvinenko. This race is 12 and a half k's long, so they're almost at the halfway point. Litvinenko, reminding you, is a gold medalist from the 7.5K. Will the extra 5 kilometres be a bit much for him? Ulieva leaves the finish area. Anklets taken from her. Lucan, 0.1 quicker than Kovalevsky. There's nothing between them at the 5.5K. Lots of the race left, but my goodness, if it were to stay like this, we'd have some kind of a finish on our hands. Lucan looking to better his silver medal in the 7.5K. Finishing behind Litvinenko in that one by 11 seconds. So it can be very tight.
assure you that's Olga Prelutska, but we can only just assure you the visibility's not very special. With the audio guided rifle system, visibility's not too much of an issue. She's got Yugoslav Rychnetsky next to her. And the miss for Prelutska. That frequency didn't get high enough. And two misses. So six altogether. And Prelutska, disappointing race for her ultimately. Needs to tidy up that aspect of her biathlon skills, and she'll be finishing races in better times. Vasily Shatshiboy. Three penalties already. Won't win it with that kind of accuracy. That's your boy. He is a B2 sport class. 98% factoring applied to his real time. Shishkova coming down to the line. And the Ukrainian, just over 35 minutes, and she will collect the bronze medal. Ponomarev. So 14 out of 14. All good through three bouts of shooting for Ponomarev. And Oleg, one of the leading Russians here. Pelukin, their best chance. Kudukov didn't start, so we can rule him out. Five from Ukraine, three from Russia, one from Belarus. So the field is actually one from Belarus, two from Russia, and the German Krem having pulled out. So eight in the field. For the men, Litvinenko. Well, that's 15 out of 15 today. Didn't miss in the 7.5K race, so that's another 10. That's 25 out of 25 for Litvinenko. Yanenko with the guide Boris Babar, 60 seconds ahead of Shatshiboy. He's had a few misses. Pelukin. Oh, and a miss. Don't see that too often from Pelukin, but we also saw it once in the earlier biathlon final, the 7.5K. And Pelukin just opens the door for Litvinenko to perhaps get another upset. Pelukin, even though he finished second in that first race, was the favourite here. Witkin. So Pelutska now, we look at coming through that checkpoint. And as you know, she's well off the pace today. Witkin, though. Just behind Shatshiboy, 2 seconds. Shulga, 2 minutes 15 down. We don't need to think about him as a potential podium place.
Lukyanenko, we do. And he's in first place. A minute and 1 second ahead of Shapshaboy. The time we'll be looking for is that of Nikolai Polukhin when he comes through that checkpoint to see how close he is to Lukyanenko. Polukhin has had to ski the penalty loop, but he was in front prior to that. And a miss, first one for Anatoly Kovalevsky. Yeah, two out of five only. That's a lot of extra skiing to do for Vitaly Lukyanenko. For Kovalevsky. Here comes Polukhin. And he is outside the time of Lukyanenko. Not by much. And he's got a good rhythm up here as he comes through the 8K checkpoint. 12 and a half Ks is the race. And he's 7 seconds down. He's a quicker skier than Lukyanenko, and there is certainly enough meters left in this race for him to make up the difference. By 7 seconds, it's Lukyanenko over Polukhin, then Shapshaboy almost a minute down on the Ukrainian. Lukyanenko, Polukhin, then Shapshaboy, then Utkin, Ponomarev, Reshnetsky, and Shuga. Raincoats the order of the day, unfortunately, at the Laura Cross Country and Biathlon Centre, some 50 kilometres away from Sochi. Been threatening to rain for the last couple of days, and unfortunately here it is, and certainly not doing the condition of the course any favours whatsoever. About now you start to think it was a wise move storing all that snow in warehouses, as Russian authorities chose to do late last year, in case we had this kind of situation in March at Laura and Rosakuta. Yaroslav Reshetsky now. Final stop at the range. Shapshaboy. Shapshaboy is quick, but he's erratic. And four penalties overall. Favor Reshetsky's more measured approach to the side of the biathlon over the Shapshaboy method. What he saves between shots, he more than loses with his inaccuracy and the time spent around the penalty loop. So Reshetsky heads out, exiting the range. Stopping the clock at 27:17 at that checkpoint. And what's happening here? Broken ski. And that is Kovalevsky, his guide. Is Alexander Mukshin. Mukshin with a broken ski. And that's terribly bad luck for Kovalevsky, who had been not so much in contention. Well, he was back in the field a little. Lukyanenko. Last shooting stop for him. Taking a little longer than previous. Oh, that was quick. So was that. And he gets the lot. Unbelievable. That is 30 out of 30 when you factor in the shooting from the 7.5K. Six times in total he's been to the range and he has not missed. Now Lukyanenko, whether he's got the pace to hold off Pelukin, if Pelukin shoots clean, well, that's what we're waiting to see. Lucan, here he is, as a B2 sport class. He's got a kinder percentage applied to his real time. But he's got to have 5 out of 5 to start with. Oh, he's getting this done brilliantly. One more, and it's on. Out he goes. Pelukin in hot pursuit of Lukyanenko. He means business, Nikolai Pelukin. There's nothing between them. I think he's just going to have Lukyanenko. And his guide, Andrei Tokarev, has set off at jet pace. And he's in front now by 1.8 seconds, Pelukin. Lukyanenko and Pelukin, a great last 2.5 Ks to be skied here between them. And I sense that Pelukin might just have done enough. If he can keep his poise, make no mistakes out on the skiing leg, that's your boy's time. Well inside it is Lukyanenko. Lukyanenko. Years old is Pelukin. Lukyanenko another 4, so it's 36-year-old Lukyanenko against 32-year-old Pelukin. Ukraine and the Russian Federation going head-to-head here in the men's 12.5K, visually impaired. Conditions are terrible. The snow's soft. We've had rain. The mist is making visibility none too pleasant. Sugar, he got out first. Dmitry Sugar and Arthur Gergaf is his guide. Pretty much outside the time of Lukyanenko. Here comes Pelukin. Oh, and he's dropped a couple of seconds. This is interesting. 2 seconds quicker leaving the range. 2 seconds slower through that checkpoint. Fascinating finish coming up here between Nikolai Pelukin and Vitaly Lukyanenko. It's on. There was 11 seconds between them in the 7.5K. With Lukyanenko getting there first. Andrei Tokarev urging on his man. Lukin crests the hill, grateful for the moment of relief it brings. So Lukyanenko by 2 seconds. That's the race between first and second, and not much between Shapshaboy and Utkin as well. So there's a real duel on for first and second, and then another for third and fourth. Pelukin won 6 medals in cross country and biathlon at the 2010 Games in Vancouver. And Lukyanenko is trying to finish the job here. And here's Pelukin. Deadly accurate. For Pelukin, there was a gold in the relay in cross-country in Vancouver as we watch Shapshaboy come down to the finish now. Just inside or just outside 32 minutes. 31.59 for Shapshaboy. There's the initial time to beat. And we've got a couple of real contenders out there in Pelukin and Lukyanenko. Here comes Ryshevsky. 23 off the pace of Shapshaboy.
This is
Kalukin's got two bronze medals from Vancouver. Two silver medals, I should say, from biathlon in Vancouver. And another silver medal here in the 7.5K. So Kalukin is certainly hungry for the gold, but he might be denied it. Utkin. Jackson Boy's time is holding up. So we're sweating on the arrival, first of all, of Vitaly Lukyanenko. Ponomarev. Sneaking into third position at the moment, 58 seconds slower than Shapshaboy. And Lukyanenko across the line in 31.04. He looks like he's given it everything. I hope he has for his sake, because there could be nothing in it when Kalukin comes across the line in a little while from now. And Lukyanenko, of course, is looking for a second gold medal. His win in the 7.5K was a bit of a shock. Vasily Shapshaboy congratulates him on his race. They've given it their best, and is it good enough? This outstanding... camaraderie between the athletes and the guys. I just love seeing how much they appreciate and respect each other. And now Lukyanenko can only wait. Here he comes, Nikolai Kalukin. 31.04 is the finish time to beat for Lukyanenko. And Kalukin. Oh, he's not going to do it. He's outside the time. We know that already. Lukyanenko has done enough. Kalukin is giving it everything. He will slot into second place. He's got Shapshaboy beaten, but Lukyanenko is too good again. 10 seconds, and it was 11 seconds in the 7.5K. Can you believe that? Almost by the same margin, the same man has beaten Kalukin. And Lukyanenko of Ukraine and his guide Boris Babar have got a second gold medal. It was 11 seconds flat in the 7.5K. It was 10.3 in this one. By a combined distance of 20 kilometers, just 20 seconds between them. It's Ukraine, Russia, Belarus. Lukyanenko, Kalukin, Shapshaboy. Kovalevsky unable to finish because of the broken ski of his guide. That's a sad story, that one. And Dolfkov of Russia, Brem of Germany, not able to make it to the start line. Again, this heartfelt congratulations being passed around between the athletes. I can't speak highly enough of the spirit of true sportsmanship that moves around the Paralympic events. It's great to see. Women's 10K, the result there, Lisova, way too good again for the field. Budalieva in second place, and Shishkova, then Kalutska for Ukraine. So Lisova, second goal for her.
Kalina Lisova yet again, too good. Yulia Budalieva and Oksana Shishkova. Here's the result for the men's. And outstanding finish we got. Vitaly Lukyanenko of Ukraine got the better of it, though, from Nikolai Palukin of Russia. And then Vasily Shapshaboy of Belarus. And considering he missed four targets, he might nearly have won the thing if he'd been as accurate as Lukyanenko. So some exciting racing certainly coming out of the Lauda Cross Country and Biathlon Centre in spite of the average conditions that presented themselves to the athletes today. We've got some flower presentations to bring you shortly, so I hope if you enjoy those that you can stay with us. And as soon as the officials have everybody ready for that, then we'll be back with you to talk you through those.
Оставайтесь всегда такими красивыми. Пусть будет 8 марта. Всем добрых дней. С праздником!